Last year, Tash Despa, a Tibetan refugee, now a British resident, returned to his homeland. He spent 3 months undercover, traveling the country to find out what life was like for ordinary ethnic Tibetans under Chinese rule. He found a highly militarized state, which is imprisoning and torturing dissenters. Women suffering forced abortions and sterilizations. And Tibet's traditional nomadic way of life under threat as thousands are forcibly resettled. Ten years ago, Tash Despa escaped across the Himalayas. He paid a guide £75, 3 months' average salary, and left his family behind, unable to see a future in a country increasingly dominated by the Chinese. Many Tibetans have traditionally existed as nomads. But in the 4 decades since the occupation, the Chinese have increasingly tried to control this way of life. The government says it is improving the living conditions of nomads and will provide 52,000 with homes in 2008. But according to a Human Rights Watch report last year, many tens of thousands of Tibetans have been forcibly resettled and had their land and livestock confiscated. Pressure groups say that living conditions for nomads in the resettlement camps are grim. To investigate this, the team drove to a camp built in the middle of an empty plain, many miles from the nearest town.
This is the houses of the nomads' families who are moved from the grassland. And I hear that there's 200 families right here now, live here. It's like a little prison, isn't it? Look. It's really sad.
The camp has been occupied for nearly 2 years, but there are no public buses in or out, so the people here have little chance to travel to find work. There is no school or clinic, and with little support for retraining, the nomads are struggling to survive. As a result, alcoholism is becoming more and more of a problem.
Okay, we should go.
Okay.
Yeah. I think it's no good to speak to anybody.
Why is that?
Because I know he doesn't trust it.
So it's not possible to go in any of the houses?
No.
So they're just fenced in behind these concrete walls, is that right?
Yeah. No more cool.
The driver's increasing anxiety was justified when the team spotted 4 police cars parked, watching the camp.
It shows you how close it's always to be caught.
It was clearly too risky to try to talk to anyone here, so the team drove to another nomad resettlement camp a couple of hours away. This time, Tash went in alone, wearing a secret camera. Although there was a noticeable police presence here too, Tash was confident that he could blend in with the locals and felt it was worth taking the risk to talk to some directly. One woman who'd been forcibly resettled from the grasslands felt so strongly about the situation of her people that she agreed to be interviewed.
Nirka
Concerned that Tash may have provoked the interest of the police by talking to locals, the team immediately left the area. Tash Despa has now been in Tibet for over 2 months investigating life under Chinese rule. After talking to forcibly resettled nomads and those who say they've suffered torture and arbitrary arrest, he is now investigating another way in which the Chinese allegedly attempt to control the Tibetan population.
I'm on the way to meet a lady who are like many women, had a forced sterilization, and she's very nervous. So we had to go to at night, so that nobody can see us. So far, we have been very, very lucky to speak to these people without any problems with the police. So we're hoping it will go very smoothly tonight.
The house should be down here, so we're nearly there. I can see the lights.
She says she had a child out of quota under the terms of China's one-child policy. As a result, she was given the choice of either a fine she couldn't pay or sterilization.
I'm
The Chinese government says the one-child policy does not apply to Tibetans. But this woman's experience is far from unique. In 2002, a UN special rapporteur said women in Tibet are subjected to forced sterilization, forced abortion, coercive birth control policies, and the monitoring of menstrual cycles. China is able to exert this intimidating control over the people of Tibet, partly through sheer numbers. Migrant workers from China have flooded into the capital in recent years, encouraged by the government. Official business has to be conducted in Mandarin, so Tibetans are at a significant disadvantage. As a result, observers estimate that around half the population of Lhasa is now Han Chinese,